I received this question the other day on Facebook, and then I thought about it for a little bit, and this is something that I could use myself for contracts that I have with companies. And so I've worked on it, and this is what I've come up with. So I have a number of sheets here. The first one is my data. And then we have what I've created a pivot table out of this. And this is what it looks like. And my experience in companies is they're not interested in seeing the pivot table at all. Everybody likes pictures. And so I've created a dashboard from this pivot table. And my dashboard looks like this. Now, routinely, I would send out dashboards to different emails regarding whatever the thing was I was analyzing. And so then I would create an email list. And so I've got a few of my emails down here. And so in A1, I have just three emails down here. Now, I put this not in the code because it... My experience is that emails change, people change positions, and that be a different person that you're changing. So allow it to be easily accessed by other people. Now, let me show you on my dashboard at the top here. I've got March 2019, but because you probably send it out monthly or every second month, you can change it to, I've got all the months in here. And so it could be April 2019 or, and then same thing with 2019, you can drop it down to be whatever. Okay. Now in my code, I'm using the March as part of my title. And I'm obviously using my email list as who I'm emailing it to. And now let's walk through the code and show you what I've done. So here is my code. I have subject sent email from Excel. I have edress as a string, subject as a string, message as a string, file name and name as a string, outlook as an object, outlook mail as an object, my attachment as an object, path as a string, attachment as a string, and x as an integer. And x equals 2 because on my email list I have titles at the top. Now we're doing a for loop or a do while loop, and I'm doing do while sheet 3, and sheet 3 from, you can see from here, sheet 3 is my email list. Do while x1, which is the A column, well, it does not equals nothing. It does not equal blank. Now, when I include this code in my description of the video, I will have to put in written does not equal to, because I'm not allowed to put square brackets in my description. Okay, so then we set up the Outlook, set Outlook app, create object, set Outlook email, Outlook create item, my attachments equals Outlook mail item attachments, and path, this is the path where I'm temporarily going to save the file to. Edress equals from the sheet 3, X1, subject equals sheet 2, so sheet 2 is my dashboard, and as I was showing you, that's the March or April that we're taking from the top of there. It's the month, and then I say and dashboard. File name equals sheet 1, whatever it is, it's going to be named the same thing, March. And then worksheets dashboard activate. Work name equals worksheet dashboard range G2 value. Worksheets dashboard range A1 to N35. And so what I've done is on my dashboard, I figure that from A1 and then I go down to the bottom, and it's N35 is where I want it to end. And so let's go back to the code. Now, so that's what I've selected to save. And selection export as fixed file, so I'm saving it as a PDF. File name equals path that I've indicated up here, plus name plus PDF. And then I am file name equals name plus PDF, attachment equals path plus file name. And then I go to Outlook mail item 2.address, outlookitem.cc equals blank, same thing with blind carbon copy, outlookmailitem equals subject, outlookmail body, and I say please find your dashboard attached, and best regards, and then my attachments and outlook display. Now I am, if you copy this code, you can take the quotation mark in front of this and your Outlook will automatically send, but I'm just going to display this. And then I say last row equals last row plus one, edress equals nothing, x equals x plus one, and then I'm going through the loop. Now, set Outlook app equals nothing, set Outlook app mail item equals nothing, so that clears it off. And then I'm not saving the attachment because you always have the Excel file. You don't need to keep this attachment. And so let's run this and see how it goes. So I'm just going to, I'm going to F8 through this. And now, it's creating all what I've asked it to. So here is my email that I've created, screamingacres@gmail.com, March dashboard, and here is my March PDF, and then here's what I'm saying, please find your dashboard attached, best regards. This would be really useful code if you're sending out of parts of pivot tables or sending out specifically the dashboard. So I will include the code in my description. Please subscribe.